Hey, what's going on, everybody? I am John from JFM Development. Today's a great day. It is Vape Mail Day. So let's get right into it. Okay, guys, so yeah, as I was saying, today's a great day. We got ourselves a nice box of vape mail right here. And today, we're going to do my first vape mail video. I haven't done a vape mail video yet, but today is the day. And yes, it's from Bull City. We got a nice package size full of flavors right here. This is jam-packed. It barely fits. It's bulging at the edges, if you can see that. So, I have two camera angles. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the normal camera that I use for the scale. I'm going to use that camera angle and my face camera angle so we can kind of get all of the cool greatness of our beloved vape mail. So I'm going to change that up right now. Okay, guys, so as you can see, this is the new face cam and we got the scale cam, so you should be able to see everything in this box right here. I got my lovely Red Bull on standby. Got to keep that energy up, right? And of course, I am vaping on my RX300 with my Goon RDA. I put a TFE8, what do you call it? It's a drip tip by, I can't think of the name right now, but it's a nice drip tip. The thing cost me a lot of money. It cost me like 15 bucks, but I really like it. Green's my favorite color. And of course, I'm hooked on this stuff. My Airhead recipe on this channel, you guys gotta check it out. It's just phenomenal. It's just phenomenal. I can't stop vaping it. And the best part is when you run out and just mix it up, you have it again right away. Good stuff. Okay. So let's get into the main attraction here. Let me see how I should open this up. Yeah, we're going to open up like this. Here we go. Oh, yeah. And take this bad boy out. What I like to do with these checklists is I like to make sure I have everything on this list. Go down and make sure they forgot nothing. But Bull City, to this point, has never forgot anything. They've been way above board. They're a great company. They're fast. If it wasn't for the holiday, I would have gotten this yesterday. And I only ordered it, I think, Friday night. Or maybe it was Saturday. No, it was Saturday. Early Saturday morning. I ordered it. And if you guys didn't know, Bull City just had a sale for... Oh, sorry. Getting in the camera view. Bull City just had a sale for 30% off all Flavora flavors. And normally, I don't like to pay the expensive price for Flavora because they are really steep. But with 30% off, it's almost like it's any other flavoring company. So I had to jump on that and get as many as I could. That kind of interested me, but it was only from a certain list that you could. So, let's get to the, right to the vape mail. Okay. So, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take all these out. So, we got 430 mils right here. And we'll go through each of them. And we got some more right here. I went way overboard again. And over here, we got four more 30 mils. A whole Dongon pack of Flavlora. And another pack of Flavlora. I almost got their whole collection. All that fits in this box, go figure, right? So I'm gonna put this to the side. I'm going to go through each one. Okay. So let's start off with this bad boy right here. Sorry if I keep looking to the side. I'm making sure I'm in the camera angles, but once I get used to it, I won't do that as much. I should probably put a monitor over here so I can actually see what's going on at a glance, so don't mind me. I'm still getting used to this new setup here. Alright. So, the first flavor is... Okay, so the first one is TFA Cheesecake. Sorry, I had to do a jump cut right there because it wasn't focusing right, and I want you guys to see the flavors. So the first one is TFA cheesecake. Now this isn't TFA cheesecake graham crust. This is just a regular cheesecake because I'm trying to master this strawberry cheesecake recipe that I used to buy from the store I go to, this vape store called Vape Ready. They had this Sam's cheesecake, and it's a strawberry cheesecake. And so far, all the cheesecake flavors I've used haven't came close. So that's why I got this. And I think that's it. Okay, so this cheesecake right here is exactly what I thought, and why I only got a really small one, because you only need a little bit to add into a mix. This one is very potent. It smells very cheesy, and you just want to use it to kind of support other cheesecake flavors. So that's why I got that one. Next up, because I'm still trying to master that cheesecake, I also got Lorraine's cheesecake, because I'm really trying to find that cheesecake flavor I'm trying to replicate. Let's see if this is it. This does smell good. You know what's weird? Like, a lot of Lorraine's cream cheese icing kind of smells like this one too. It's kind of like they have similar scents, if that makes sense. Wow. Can't believe I just said that. Okay. Yeah, it kind of smells like cream cheese icing. I'd like to compare those two, but that's Lorraine's cheesecake right there. All right. Next up is Capella Raspberry. If I can open this bad boy. Capella Raspberry. There we go. All right. Ooh. Let me try some of that one. I think that would go good with Raspberry Sweet or Sweet Raspberry by TFA. Definitely gonna try. It kind of tastes more tastes a little bit more bold, if that makes sense. Like, I don't know if you would say ripe, but I don't know. I'm gonna have to figure out a better way to describe that one to you guys, but it is different than sweet raspberry. Kind of has a fuller taste. Kind of tastes a little bit more complex, if that makes sense. All right, I'm gonna put my trash to the side, try to keep this as organized as possible. All right. Next up, we're gonna do some of these 30 mils right here. So, first 30 mil is TFA Wild Blueberry. Smell that one. You know, that smells kind of like, hold on, let me try it. Wow, it kind of tastes like a mix of like one of those blue lollipops, and also it kind of tastes like a mix between was it Blueberry Extra and Bilberry, but just a little bit. Like, it kind of has a little bit of an earthy taste to it, but it also has a little bit of a candy taste. That's Blueberry Wild. Next up, TFA Raspberry. Yeah, I want to get a lot of different raspberry and blueberry flavors this time, so I had them to work with. Okay, this one is Real, this one smells really potent. Try this one out. Oh, wow. This one tastes more like to me, it's coming off more like a Jolly Rancher type, like a raspberry candy. But I think I got raspberry candy too, unless that's what that is. But I think I got raspberry candy. But this raspberry tastes a lot on the candy side, kind of like a Jolly Rancher. Don't mind me, just gotta crack open another Red Bull. I know I should really stop drinking this stuff, but. Okay. Let's do this one next. PFA Swedish gummy. Now I got this one because I saw a DIY vapor using it and it really intrigued me. Because lately I've been liking candy vapes, so I'm gonna wanna try to make a lot of different candies. Wow. That just tastes exactly like Swedish fish, but in a bottle. That's insane. Ooh, I'm gonna have some fun with this bad boy. Oh, yeah. That's gonna be fun. Okay. Next up. Now, here's one that I have a lot of different other companies, and it is Capella Vanilla Bean Ice Cream. Now, I have like Flavor West Vanilla Bean Ice Cream, TFA Vanilla Bean Ice Cream, but I've been hearing a lot about Capella Vanilla Bean Ice Cream and how it's thicker and creamier. So I really want to give it a shot. I mean, this is really exciting for me. I really hope it does come out good. Let's give it a little smell. Let's try it out. If Wow, that one's good too. I like to try them side by side and compare the differences. So we got a lot of flavors to be working with, guys. It's gonna be fun. Okay. Next up, take a vape break. Let me know how you guys like the new camera angles and all that. I think it's pretty cool. Right. Next baggie. Don't worry, we're gonna save the flavor to last, guys. I don't know if you guys are excited for those, but I certainly am. I hope they're all they're cracked up to be, at least price-wise. Okay. Next up. Oh, got a piece of tape on the bottle. Okay. Next up, another candy one. TFA Sweet and Tart. If you guys couldn't tell by now, I really want to explore candies. Because after making this one right here, and it being so good to me, which I never really vaped candies until I started DIYing. But maybe I just like my own mixing. But let me tell you, they are very, very good. Like, I can't stop vaping this one. Okay, so here we go. TFA Sweet and Tart. This is supposed to be like, sweet tarts. Wow, it like smells like a sweet tart, and it also smells like pixie sticks, sort of. Oh, cool. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. I don't know about you guys, but I get way too excited about this stuff. This stuff makes my day. Wow. Okay. Following the candy trend, we got Flavor West Jawbreaker. Flavor West Jawbreaker. And here's another one that was inspired by Chris's work. Chris is a lot into candies, and I saw a lot of these flavors. Like, I've seen them before, and they interested me, but I never really made too many candies. And after I made this one, I started taking notice of more of his candy stuff he had, and I'm like, well, if he's using them and he's had good luck and there's a lot of good reviews on them, well, it must be a good flavor to pick up, don't you think? All right, jawbreak, here we go. Okay. Okay, I get that. This one doesn't taste as strong though. I noticed that with some Flavor West flavors, some of them don't taste as strong as the others. That isn't always true. That isn't always true, but some of them, that's like one of them that doesn't taste as strong as some other of their counterparts. Then again, I don't think there is another company that makes Jawbreaker. Or at least I haven't noticed it yet, but there are so many flavors, it's almost impossible to keep up with them all. Okay, next up. Flavor Art Raspberry. Right, let's give this bad boy a smell. Oh, this is entirely different than the TFA and Capella. This one tastes really full-bodied. Wow. Okay, let's try this. I'm trying to find a spot in my hand. I haven't done it yet. Wow, that one's strong too. Okay, yeah. I can see myself layering this with other raspberries. This one seems like it's a nice body. It's like kind of like what I refer to as a base, like it's a building block. I don't know if I'd necessarily use Flavor Art Raspberry alone, but I would definitely use it in conjunction with other flavors. It just tastes like it. It tastes like it. It's a piece of the raspberry flavor profile, if you know what I mean. Think of it like, well, this is how I think of layering a lot of the times. I think of it like as a kind of like a puzzle piece, okay? You need so many pieces to complete the puzzle, and for one flavor, you might need, say, Flavor Art Raspberry, Capella Raspberry, and TFA Sweet Raspberry. And that will complete the flavor profile that you're specifically trying to get by one mix you're trying to make. But that, of course, isn't always the case, and it's going to vary from mix to mix depending on what taste you're trying to get. But I feel raspberry will definitely help me get me there. That makes sense. Okay, now. Was it the wild blueberry? Yeah, so remember how I showed you I got the wild blueberry, right? Now I have blueberry candy. As I said, I want to get all the different fruits, or the main fruits, to mess around with them. Especially the candy one, but that wild blueberry kind of tasted like it was candy-ish, so really interested to see what this one is. Okay. Okay, yeah. I could see how it's a little bit candy-ish on the candy side, but what I would probably do is these probably. I can't speak. These probably together, blueberry wild and blueberry candy, I think they're gonna go good together. Yeah. Yeah, they're gonna go good together. All right, I'm getting too excited. Too excited. All right, guys. I know you're probably like, oh, this is so boring watching him go over his flavors yapping on. I only have a little bit left. I felt loud. It's too many. I bought too many. Telling you guys though, if you want a good vape, good quick one that you can make right away, this Airhead vape, man. This is my third bottle that mixed up on the fly. And vaping the shit out of it. And what? Is this like a week period? So pretty much vaping this, a little bit of stuff when I want something different, but mainly this, man, is so good. I should have bought more of the concentrate, but then again, those 30 ml bottles of taffy and all that will last a long time. So, let's do the smaller bottle, smaller bag first. Wow. That's so strange. They individually bag every one. I guess with the price you pay for them, you get a little bit extra protection. They double bag them, guys. They double bag them. Okay. So the first one. Now, there is a good reason why I bought this one. First of all, because of the 30% off sale that was this past weekend. So if you didn't take advantage of it, it's too late, guys. I'm sorry about that. But there's a 30% off sale at Bull City for Flavor, as I was saying before. And why can't I open this? Oh, that's because they're not Ziploc bags. Not all of them, at least. Okay, so there was a reason behind why I bought this one. Luckily, I have my cool scissors right here. Okay. So, I bought this one because another one of my DIY mixing buddies who was on YouTube, he goes by the name of Blind Views. He does DIY videos and he also does commentary. Let's just say commentary. And he was, you know, trying a different style of video and he was trying to make a candy apple. And he was asking the audience how to go about it. So then when I saw this, I'm like, wow, I gotta get this. This seems like it'll help me get there. It's Flavora Apple Pop. It's supposed to be the candy. Well, in the picture, at least, they showed a candy apple. So that's what I think that's going to do. And I was like, well, let me get that and try that out. So let's shake it up. Let's give this a test. Candy apple. Oh. Wow. This is like in a whole nother league of its own. What? Guys, that is good. But it's weird. It doesn't. It tastes like the candy apple, but it also kind of tastes like spiced apple, like apple spice, like apple cider. That's gonna be a fun flavor to mess with. Oh yeah. Trying to make sure this is on tight. Okay. So there's that one. Followed by Flavora bubble gum. Give this one a gander. If I can get it open. So as you can see, I've been doing a lot of candy stuff lately. Okay, let's see. Oh. Tastes like bubblegum. Tastes like bubblegum with maybe. It tastes like bubblegum with maybe a little bit of mint. Not too much, just a little bit. I don't know if it's like a wintergreen or. I don't know, or maybe that's the alcohol that's in the flavoring. There must be alcohol in there. I'm not sure. I'm going to have to do some more research on that one, but that one's going to be fun to mess with. Okay. Next up. Flavora Blood Orange. Now, I want to get Blood Orange because I'm still working on finding that perfect orange for Flintstone. And I still haven't found a perfect orange, in my opinion. That to me tastes like more of a candied orange. It tastes like one of those orange lollipops that you get from like a bank or something when you're a kid. That one's pretty good. Okay, here's another exciting one. This is, wait for it, apple filling. Try this one out. Oh. Yeah, I know, that just got weird, but you know when you smell something that smells really good and you're just like, hallelujah. What I just got when I smelled this stuff right here. Apple filling. Wow. By the time you guys watch this video, you're probably gonna think I'm insane because how excited I'm getting, but this stuff is awesome. It's very strong too, but it tastes like everything you need in apple filling. The one thing that I am noticing though is it seems like it's very strong on the cinnamon. Very strong. So, but the apple is there. So this one is probably going to be like, it's kind of steep. I heard flavors are really fast at steeping, but this one, it's going to be good, but you're going to want to use it low because it's really strong and you're going to want to build off of it. But this one is going to make a freaking awesome pie. And I'm still working on making an awesome apple pie. So that for sure is going to be a good addition. Okay. Next up, of course, you guys are all going to understand. If you watch my channel before, you'll understand why I bought this one. Berry blend. Hello, Harvest Berry, one of my favorites. Definitely had to pick this bad boy up. Okay. I gotta stop doing that. I gotta stop doing that. Wow. Oh, this one smells so good too. Wow. That's good. You can taste like the different berries, like raspberry, blueberry. Instead of it tasting more jumbled up, like you can almost taste the individual flavors, and they're like bold, dark flavors. They're not like candy type flavors. So this one is gonna be really good. Man, maybe I've been missing out. Where's Flavor been my whole life? I mean, maybe that's why they're so expensive. But I gotta use them sparingly because I don't know about you, but Flavor is expensive to afford. Then again, if you look at the price per 30 mil, if you bought it at the store, are they really that expensive? Not really, because they'll make a lot. So I don't know. It's just hard to justify when you have TFA that's like a quarter of the price. But you know, if they have stuff that I can't go without, then I'm for sure gonna order it again. But the other thing is, you can only get them in 15 mils. But if I'm wrong about that, leave it in the comments below. I'd really love to know, because I'm not entirely sure. But everywhere I've seen, I think it's only been 15 mil bottles. Okay. Next up, cookie dough. Now, I got cookie dough because I've heard somebody raving about it, and it was Jennifer Jarvis. And if you don't know who Jennifer Jarvis is, you should really check her out. She has a website called DIY e-liquid mixology, I believe. And she also has a YouTube channel by the same name, DIY e-liquid mixology. Her name's Jennifer Jarvis. She's really cool in the community. She helps out a lot of people. And that lady is all about the flavor. Or at least that's what I gather from her. But she's a really cool shit. She's really cool shit. And I heard about her in one of her videos. She was talking about how she was doing cookie dough flavors. So I saw this and saw that I could get 30% off it, and I'm like, well, I gotta pick that up. I love cookie dough. One of my favorite ice creams is chocolate chip cookie dough. So I had to pick this one up and give it a shot. So let's smell this one out. Hmm. I'm gonna smell. It smells like there is chocolate in there. Wow. This one's gonna be fun to mess with. We get a lot more videos, guys. But see, you know what? I'm gonna do like maybe videos with Flavor maybe once a week because I'm gonna have my daily mixes. But I might do mixes with Flavor maybe once a week because the thing is they are expensive and I can't afford to be, throwing away the flavors for one. And two, I can't expect to like make end all be all recipe and then you guys have to pick up all these Flavor flavors. I don't think that's fair to you guys, but let me know what you think about that in the description because Flavor is expensive. Like, I can't even say, like, I mean, I could look on here, but like, say you have one of these, they're $5, and then you have another one that's $8, and another one that's $12. Like, you kidding me? So, you can't. I don't want to do that to you guys. I don't want to have you guys having to pick up all these expensive flavors. So, we're on the last bag now. The last bag is the biggest bag, and we have been going for almost a half hour already. So I gotta speed this up because you guys are probably getting so bored by now. Dokie. Right. Next up is another one I'm really excited for. I picked this one up because there are so many e-liquids that are out in the mainstream that are based off of this, and I'm still trying to make a really good one. And it's vanilla pudding. And they all have like these pudding e-liquids, and I want to try to make a good pudding, like pudding powder and all these other ones, so. Play on my palate. Okay. Right, that one's gonna be interesting to work with. This one's definitely gonna be a building block. So I'll let you know more about the vanilla pudding later down the road. Okay, here's another one in my cheesecake venture. So if you guys don't know, I already just said it. It's Flavora cheesecake. As I was saying earlier, I'm really trying to nail a good cheesecake, and I figured if I have them, then I can nail it, right? Okay. Flavor cheesecake followed by red raspberry. Let me know in the comments too, like if you guys are still watching by chance, but let me know in the comments down below if when I get vape mail, if you want me to try them like I am, or if you just want me to list them off, or if you have a problem with these longer videos, I would love to know. Okay, also, Flavor red raspberry. As I said, I'm trying to get all the raspberries and blueberries and strawberries, the main fruit. Okay. That's different. All right, this one tastes to me, this red raspberry to me tastes more like a puree or when you have like a sugary blended raspberry mix. That's exactly what it tastes to me. And I used to work at Orange Julius when I was young, when I was like 14. I worked at Orange Julius, and the raspberry puree tasted exactly like that. So I'm gonna venture a guess and saying that would be awesome in a triple berry smoothie because that was my favorite. And that's probably what I'm gonna do with that one. But it tastes exactly like that. Alright, here's another one. We're almost at the end, guys. We're almost at the end. Bear with me. I'm going to try to speed up. Okay, this one is berry cheesecake. And of course, I had to get the cheesecake or the berry one too, right? Oh, yeah. That one smells awesome. Wow, that's strong. Wow. It burns. It burns. Woo. There has to be alcohol in there. Wow. Hey, guys. I think I'm going to be tasting berry all day now. Wow. Like, it numbed up my mouth. I took way too much. Wow. Okay. I'm going to venture a guess and say that one is a very strong one. Use that at small percentages. Wow. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to taste anything else now. Ugh. Okay. Show must go on. The show must go on. All right. Next up, Flavora cherry filling. Okay, shake her up. So we have cherry filling and apple filling. Okay, I'm not going to try this one, but this one does smell very good. And I'm trying to make a good cherry berry flavor. And I think this might help get me there. Doesn't taste too much like chemicals or nastiness. Ah, here's the one I've been waiting for. Now, I've had my eyes on this one for a while. Because I've been trying to get that perfect topping. And it's Flavora frosting. I've been trying to get a good frosting flavor for a while. And this one has had my eye, but it's always been too much. So, I never really got it. So, I really hope this one's really good. Alright, I'm going to attempt to try this one. Oh, that's so good. Oh, that is good. Okay. Yeah, that's definitely going to have a nice home. Alrighty. We're almost at the end. Five more, guys. Five more. Alright. Tangerine by Flavora. Is this the one? I think this might be the one. Oh, well, I don't know if this is the one, but this one is so good. This might just be the best orange I've tried so far. Tangerine. Orange. Whatever. Don't judge me. Okay. Ooh, yeah. Wait, what? Oh, okay. Alright, next one. Almost there, guys. Almost there. And this one is Flavora Cookie. Flavora Cookie. Okay, this one tastes a lot like F.A. But it at least tastes way better than F.A. It's more cookie, like gooey cookiness than dry cookiness, if that makes sense. Again, I gotta mess with it to see, because how it tastes and how it vapes might be two different things, so. Plus, I got all the rest of the other flavors in my mouth. All right. Sweet dough. Now there was the options. Hold on, let me put in the camera for you. Sweet dough by Flavor. Now there were the options for sweet dough and fried dough. But I heard a lot of people saying negative stuff about the fried dough, but the sweet dough was to die for. To die for. So I know I just repeated myself, but that's exactly what they said. They said the sweet dough is where it's at, and the fried dough is meh, you know? So that's why I picked this one up. I forgot where I heard that from, otherwise I would say it, but I remember hearing it. Okay, let's try this one out. Oh god, that's strong. Why do I do this to myself? Oh. Alright, I'm gonna have to do some flavor testing. Obviously, it's kind of like Yellow Cake and all them that have to come out in the vape later. It takes a while. Oh, it's so strong. Woo! Okay. This is getting a little crazy, guys. It's getting a little crazy. So much and overwhelming. Alright. So we got the last ones out now. The last two, guys. Last two. And I saved the potentially best for last. And the first one is strawberry filling. Because, of course, what would this be without strawberries? Okay. Wow, for some reason that helped. Okay, guys. This stuff is super strong. Again, what I'm noticing with Flavora is they are super strong. So you're going to want to go low. Believe it or not, once I put some of this cranberry Red Bull in my mouth, it started to taste like strawberry. So that just goes to show you how it's overpowering that. And I just put a little drop in there. So, this stuff seems like it's going to be good, but I'm going to have to do a lot of testing, especially with percentages. So, if this stuff is as potent as it seems, maybe 15 mils isn't such a bad deal. Okay. And last up, strawberry smash. Oh yeah. If I can get this bad boy open. That one smells like another strong one, so I'm gonna be very careful. Yeah, I think this is another strong one. I'm going to have to mess around with these strawberries. They seem very potent. So I'm going to have to make like a flavor tester of them and test them out and see how they go. I can't really say off the bat. They are very strong and they taste very chemically off the bat. So I can't give you an honest opinion about it. But chances are they're just super concentrated, so when you taste them on your tongue, you're not really getting a really good taste. You're getting a big chemical taste. So, guys, thank you so very much for watching my first vape meal ever with my new format, with my new camera angles. And thank you for bearing with me as I'm still getting used to this whole vape meal thing. And, you know, as time goes by, I'll get better in all things, but I'm trying to improve everything for you guys. So, if this is your first time watching my channel, please subscribe. It really helps the channel out, and that way you get notified when new videos come out. And also, put a like on this video, all of you. Please, just stop and smash that like button right now, because what it does is it helps put my YouTube video higher in search. so people see my videos and watch them, and it really helps me out, and that way I can put more into the channel. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know your questions, comment, or concerns, or if you want to see me mix any one of these flavors I showed you today, or just anything. So thank you again for watching. I will see you in the next video. Peace.